Battle Reunion. This one's gonna suck. I'm not even being funny. This one's gonna take forever. Forever. Like, you, I'm serious. It's not even gonna be the worst one of the game as well. There's one that's gonna be even worse, but I'm kinda looking forward to the one that's worse, because, like, I'm prepared for it to be long and you know. I'd rather wield axes and javelins, because at least they're like more damage, you know. It's and we still can't buy silver bows. Ooh, can. Fucking $2,000, man. $2,000 for a silver bowl. Like, I can't be buying them. Just making sure we've got enough of them. Okay. Am I bringing back the sponge? I could bring back the sponge. Sponge? Ooh. Put that in the convoy. Yeah. We'll take the speed and defense. That's what we want. One more speed for him. Oh, thank you. I really want this game to be over, you know. You know what I mean? I want this game to be over, and I'm like too busy thinking about how we're going to make it easier. You know? Yeah, it is. And it's a shame, because I quite like a lot of the characters, do you know what I mean? And I like certain things about it, like the early 2000s feel I get from the game, and it's got a nostalgic feel in this game, and I like the character designs. I really like the artwork, you know? There's a lot of good things about this game, but this the bad things outweigh the good, you know? I'd never recommend this mod to anybody. Unless they're looking to actually quit Fire Emblem, because it's just so boring. That's all, you know. The enemy phases last too long in that, but the game is definitely better on hard mode. Would any let it put you off? On hard mode, I think it'll be a much better experience, just because, you know, the enemies didn't have 50 fucking HP and 25 defense and fucking spawns and spawns of them. That's maniac, that, but. Like I say, Maniac just turns up the problems of Path of Radiance, so. For me. Well, it used to be quite a bad thing though, Tom, because everybody used to get upset with me being honest, do you know what I mean? I used to give my opinion on, like, modern day Resident Evil games, and people would just leave, and I was like, okay, well, you fucking asked, you know, that's what I used to say, it's like, you asked, like, why, yeah, you know. I used to tell people, don't ask me if you don't want my honest opinion on a game. You know, I'm allowed my opinion, you know? Fuck. You know what I'm saying, though? Like, at least Fire Emblem fans are actually open to, like, hearing criticism about the games. It's like, you can have a discussion about it. Whereas, like, when it comes to, like, most modern day games, most people are just like, oh, I don't even want to hear it. I don't want to hear your bullshit. You know, it's just, oh, like, shut up, you know? Like, go to a fanboy Reddit page if you want to just agree with everybody. The only reason I ever give criticism on games is because it's mostly good games I give criticism on, you know? Just because I feel like they can be better in so many ways. And it's like, this is an older Fire Emblem. Of course it could improve in so many ways. And they did, you know? It's like, they improved for the next one even, you know? They improved for the next game. I'm just like, yeah, I can see some serious problems with this game though. Serious problems, and I understand why it's not like played a lot on its like maniac mode, and I understand why they took out this mode in the game, because it's actually that trash, you know, it's that trash, you know, it's not a fun Fire Emblem experience, that's all. And the only way to make it fun is by speeding up the animations, which is cheating. So it's not cheating, but like, you know, you're easing your experience. You're changing the way it's meant to be played. It's not meant to be played like that. That's where I'm coming from. You know, man, I'm getting sick of how much I say, you know, it's just like, what the hell? And I think the reason with that is too, though, is like, because I've been playing games for fucking yonks, man. I mean, like, ages. I've been around since the Master System era. You know what I mean? Like, of playing games. And it's just like, I've seen generations of games. And it's just like, you know, I sometimes can't believe, like, how some games are. And it's just like, you know, like, games are... The whole entire thing about video games is gameplay. Even though storytelling is amazing, and I think you need both. Like, don't get me wrong, I do. I think you need both. But, like, games were invented with the sole purpose of, like, gameplay. The gameplay is, like, the biggest thing about video games. Like, when they first made them, it's all about gameplay. There's no story. It's all about how good the gameplay is, and that is how the games were judged. And the story was, like, a bonus. But, like, now I feel like we need a good balance of both. I really do. I feel like we need a 50-50 balance. But there's so many games now that just, like, don't care about the gameplay. They just care about the story. And I just think that hurts a game even more than having, like, gameplay, better gameplay over story. It's just, and that's maybe just because I've been around since the Master System era, and, like, I've been around all that era, the Mega Drive, gently, you know, Sega Saturn and PS1. I've seen so many evolutions of the games, and I've been there for them all. I've, like, had almost every console growing up, and I was pretty lucky, you know. But yeah, I've seen so many games and had so many game experiences that some of these games these days, like Final Fantasy VII Remake, I just can't get behind it. I just cannot get behind it, because, like, the gameplay is so average, and like, it's just so, like, you know, it's just all about its story. The game's just cashing in on nostalgia only on people. They're just like, here's Cloud, here's Tifa, here's all them, and that's all yous want. That's all yous like, you know, that's all yous are getting, you know, like, hopefully the gameplay is enough for yous. But there's so many people that are like, I don't know, they just love the story over gameplay now, that, like, the gameplay is suffering, you know, and I think it's bad. I don't think you should, like, be making people have forced walk-in, and I don't think you should call an RPG... I don't think RPGs should be that linear either, like Final Fantasy VII Remake and stuff, you know? It's, yeah, because I've seen and played a lot of RPGs. Yeah. But, like, the fact is, they're condensing RPGs down now into, like, linear experiences, because people can't be bothered with the huge open world games, and I get that too. But, like, it's also, you can't call it an RPG. You should be calling it an interactive fucking movie experience, you know? It's, you know. So that's just where I stand on it on some games, you know. I need equal gameplay and good storytelling, you know, I do. And I think, like, Xenoblade Chronicles are, like, the more later games that I actually think do that, you know, like, great storytelling that make you care, and equally amazing gameplay, you know. It's just like, there's not many games that do it anymore. And, like, Fire Emblem as well is, like, so good for me now. I'm so glad I found Three Houses in this series in general. The gameplay is just, like, crazy outstanding. I might be sitting here talking mad shit about this game, but it's still better than half the shit I've played these past couple of, you know what I mean, these past couple of years. It still is, even on Maniac. I'd rather, like, sit here playing Maniac than Final Fantasy VII Remake. Like, that's what I mean. I'm not, like, the only reason I'm criticizing this is because it could have been actually really, really good if they had tried with this Maniac mode, but, you know. Oh, you started in 98. Yeah, I'd seen a couple of generations before, like, before we got to the Super Mario 64 days, man, and that was, like, that's why I still consider Super Mario 64, like, so good. and the N64 generation in general. Because, like, the games we had seen before it were impressive, and then, like, the PS1 era and Sega Saturn came along where they were trying 3D stuff, and obviously it's PS1 and Sega Saturn era is fantastic, and is, like, a classic, you know? But then, like, this, like, that huge jump into 3D, and I feel like the N64 is the first console that really pulled it off as well as it could be done, was like Super Mario 64. I just remember playing that game and being like blown away at how good it was, because I feel like they tried to make some of the best games ever at those periods of time, and I think that's why they still stand up today as good as they do, you know. I really do, because that's why Zelda Ocarina of Time is still like one of my favorite games ever made, and I still think it stands the test of time, because I think Nintendo actually were trying to make the best games ever at that point in time, and I think they basically succeeded, because I think Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time is up there as one of the best games ever made for me, you know. And Super Mario 64, it's like no many games are better than that, you know. You got your new Marios these days, which I also feel are a wee bit of a step down over something like 64, you know. Like, I feel like Galaxy was the last really good one they made, the Galaxy. But I didn't like Odyssey on the Switch, because I felt like I'd played it before, and I felt like I'd played a better version of it before, you know. Super Mario 64, it's like, but that's how it goes with generations. I need to understand as well, and I do, that, like, I think creating games, they didn't create games with, like, 30-year-old dudes in mind. You know, it's like, that's just not how they go about games. They're not like, oh, we made Super Mario 64 when this guy was young, you know, we made this when he was 30, whatever. Like, they're trying to make impressions on kids as well, who are, like, growing up now. And I get that, you know. I don't think a lot of people do get that, though. You know, it's like, there's no need in having, like, an evolution of gameplay. But I can't help but turn around and be like, I've played a better Mario game than this 20 years ago. Because I have. Yeah, it's like that simple, you know. But I get it. But I think, like, what Sony and that are doing these days with their interactive movie experiences are taking it a bit too far. Like, at least at the end of the day, I still have fun playing, like, Mario Odyssey, because it's really good, good gameplay, and, you know, keeps me entertained. But, like, the newer Sony exclusives just don't do anything for me, because I might as well just watch the story on YouTube, and I'll save myself a full-priced game, you know? It's, you know what I'm saying? That's why I kind of do like Nintendo these days, because, like, I still feel like they're making gameplay games with great stories. It's like, yeah. He never fell off. He was never fucking on, Tom. That was Boyd's problem. He's never on. There's nothing to get off. You know? Look at this fucking trash, dude. 50 HP per one of these enemies. Oh my goodness. Oh my god, and I only get to bring 11 dudes? You're taking the piss. And we've got to get through this bullshit in 15 turns. Gotta somehow fight through this bullshit in 15 turns. And everything's got 2 range. An unpromoted Lance Knight. Halberdier, oh thank fuck for the Halberdier. Another unpromoted Lance Knight. A Valkyrie with 8 defense. A sniper with shit speed. A sniper with slightly better speed, but he's got a longbow. And then we've got Joffrey. Then we've got Joffrey, who is good though, looking at him, you know. And he also has the Paragon, so he would actually be pretty easy to, like, cap out, you know? Still, though, I mean, I could arrive... I feel like I could arrive early if I did just send Jill over there. I mean, we can't just fly over there and arrive. So I feel like we've got that in the bag in that regard. I think it wouldn't be too bad, you know, but because we've got the full guard on. Unless she gets surrounded, it's the only way. And even then, I don't think they'd kill her, but... We could, like, end this map quicker than I... It might be harder than I think, but... I feel like we could just fly around, you know? There's no siege tomes here, which are, like, Jill's biggest threat. And you could end this map quick, but... I do want to get some XP, and I do want to get the houses, and I'll kill as many as I can with the scrubs. You know? This is going to have to be the lamest shit ever. I'm gonna have to keep all my squidgies back as far as I can. And actually just put Kieran and Oscar in there. And Jill, and like keep them far back so they can't, like, because they're running into range and they're just going to go hit our squidgies now. And like none of them have taken any damage on player phase because of the amount of shitty 2 range in this game. Now let's watch all this nonsense first though, please. Yeah. Fucking hating this level already. I'm serious though. Fine, they're gonna move up to heal, and that's okay. You know? Okay. Oh, mate. Want this guy to eat shit. Oh, I dodged it. That guy's 3 damage can piss off, honestly. I don't even need it here. I don't even know why you're here, dude. Right, so this huge Wyvern Lord. Can take a hike. Yeah, the lance is down. That kind of sucks. Just wondering how we're going to kill the boss. I need to get Nihil. It might be one of those things where we, like, get it and then end the map kind of thing, you know? I don't know. See these strats here? Putting the javelin on after the silver breaks, you know. Strats are real. I'm not too sure what those guys are doing. Are they going for the house or no? Like, you know? This guy died on turn 8. You know? Holy shit. Why would you not give him an elixir, bro? Like, come on. Fucking gave all these enemies vulneraries. Look at all them. Oh, but those guys have elixirs. I feel like I'm going to put Jill here, though. And she can clog this bit up. While Oscar... and Kieran come down here and really just help with this, because this is the area that's harder. This is the, like, I think this is the area that needs fucking sorted so we can move up here, you know? I really do. I feel like I should put Jill here, you know? That's so bad. Got to start on these guys, hopefully. Fine. And stay away from them, you know? And have these guys come in and get killered, you know, like, could work. As many down as we can. Yeah. That's what we're looking for. The big dog's going in. That's a problem there. Like, there's a good chance this guy might run, but she would be safe there, but not in a good spot. See how this goes. No looking to, and I really wish I could have put like the killer on her here or something, but it is what it is. We need to clear this little area here quickly so that we can clear this area and then block the bridge and hopefully get by the bridge. Nice. Of course they're gonna go for the axe user, you know? So they've got a good chance of dodging. I feel like they might go for Oscar, the paladins, but hard to say. Oh man, that's so good, dude. Like, honestly, I hope we do it. I do, though. I would like to kill these guys here. Take the defense. Yep. It's a shame we're no fucking one round in these guys. This makes making me wish I maybe did put the forge on. I'm trying to save the forge for more difficult chapters, but I don't know. Oh wow, these guys are just moving. Those guys over the bridge. I find that fucked up. Like, you don't need to be in the range for them to aggro, but like, how am I supposed to get through all that, you know? I really don't know. There's fucking... How many paladins? Seeing this? I need to put Oscar and that in there. Yeah, this is bad here because those guys are just going up, you know, like. All of them, yeah. I feel like we need to slow that down because if Joffrey dies, it's a GG, you know, but. It's like, I'm gonna have to put them in there against the Wyverns. Nothing I can do. It's gonna have to be done. And up there, so like at least they can't like fly over, you know. The two range, can't do much about it. Like I need to put on. Oh man, they've all got two range. Fucking trash. Still though, if I can go up the right hand side and just keep them all over there. I like that these guys are still going for Jill. Awesome. I need to rush up there and stop them getting a Joffrey. Nice. Got a hit though. Nice. Clear as many as you fucking can, bruv. Just fucking clear them, you know? Don't miss. Come on. Alright. We're getting through here with Oscar and Kieran a wee bit better, but... Thing is, I'm a wee bit worried about the bridge on the left too. Like, yeah, these guys are gonna start going down the bridge. Fine. That's what I was worried about. I was wondering when they were gonna choke that. It's like, how am I supposed to get up there and save the green units, though? If I need Jill choking that area. Might have to bring in the forge, though, and just deal with that whole area. Wish these guys can get there. I We'll see. This is, like, beyond a joke. I need to stop that choke point, though. And I can't do anything with my honor units now, because, like, there's only a few people that can handle this. We'll see how this goes now, though. Yeah. All I need is, like, a couple of bits. All I need is, like, a couple of bits here. Choked. Then we can move in amongst it, hopefully. I try and lure these guys up the left and slowly move up with Oscar and Kieran, which is what I'm thinking about doing. Joe can keep these guys busy. At least if Oscar and Kieran are up here, we can actually protect Joffrey, you know. We can maybe stop these guys. Put the javelins on and hope for the Smeggin best, you know. Look at that. Okay, so with Tanith, we can move forward a wee bit here. Have them go over here, you know? It's like... with Ike, I'm gonna have to... Nobody can get any. Are they gonna, like, come over for us? There's a good chance they could, like, come for us. Because I've no, like, got anywhere they can go. I don't know where they'll go here. Maybe they just go to the closest enemies in their vicinity. It's really hard to say. That's not what I wanted. Yeah, we'll see how this goes. We're still just basically fucking stalling here. Like, I need these guys to be, like, intrigued with Jill. I don't want this guy to be intrigued with her, though, because he's the guy who's dealing damage. These guys... can't hit there. This is fine. As long as we can, like... He's got a killer lance, and that's scary. That's the thing. What I'm looking to do is just get this house and end the map, if I can. Like, I'm not being funny here. If I can get up there, you know. We'll see how it goes. Yeah. Rough. I need Dame to, like, choke this bridge if we can... Depends on where these guys are going to. Like, we're trying to, like, basically bait them up, you know? That's no easy. Like, it depends on where they fancy going. This is fucking bullshit. And we keep missing. But, like, I think we're better keeping the two range on. It's hard to say. So at least we'd be chipping people down. Like, I honestly need Joffrey to get healed, man. I need him to get healed, or he's fucking dead, you know? Oh, shit. We could maybe use the dudes as fodder. That's kind of that was like the plan, you know. That's good. The threat for Jill's kind of gone there, but they're going over there. Cool. He's dead. Shocking. Now Joffrey's exposed. Please kill somebody. Oh no, we're not doubling him. Not even with max speed. At least we can kill them though, but... I'm looking for our other guys not to be getting sandwiched here. Put Ike in a bush, maybe. Kieran taking some damage. Okay, at least they're all going up there, dude. They were like baiting them over, that's the plan. Oh shit, that sucks. Like, I can't have her. See, she's Joffrey's healer, right? And if she dies, nobody's healing. Yeah, this is fucking so bad. I don't know how we're gonna do it. I just need to make it to the end. But... I can't believe they never gave Joffrey anything to heal himself with. If his healer gets hit, she heals herself over him. That's what I'm saying. I'm a bit worried about that bit down there, though. I think we're fucked, you know? Personally. He's I can't believe he doesn't want to heal himself or anything. He's fucking dead. I don't know how we're supposed to save him. Like, we can't even get to, like, turn fucking... See what I mean? I don't know how we're supposed to do this. Man, there's a few people that are like vulnerable here, but I'm hoping they're going to go for the Holy Guards if I just maybe get rid of some of them. I don't know. Like, I feel like these guys actually appeared like two turns earlier than what I was... I feel like they actually are... What makes them move is getting to a certain part on the map, actually, by the looks of things. You know? Yeah, I am gonna rescue Racing, like, just to be fucking safe, dude. It's like, I don't know though, this is tough. Because when they move, like, someone like Mist is gonna be exposed and... Yeah. It's rough going that. 20 speed. We'll see what goes down, man. I'm hoping that the they could just go for her too, though. It's hard to say, you know. But I'm hoping these guys are going to be good enough bait, man. It's really what I'm hoping. They've all got short spears. It's fucking disgusting. Disgusting. Can't even go here. Gonna have to go here with her. Yeah, I think that's a GG right there. I think it's a GG. Because they're just moving away, you know, like out of my fucking bit. Like they fucked my wall up there, but it's kind of like my fault. I think they're just gonna go one shot Mist or something, you know? Or go for them, which was the fucking plan! Let's go! Yes! Now, I'll tell you right now, there's obviously another way out of this level. I don't know what it fucking is. You need more experience on this level, this game, to know what the fuck is even going on here. You know? I don't even know if we're going to make it up there in time. But hopefully we'll be able to wall it for like another turn, you know? Fuck. I don't know if Oscar's going to be able to get in there. There might be a swordmaster in the fucking way. Please stop going for Joffrey. Please. Somebody heal him. Somebody heal him. Please don't die. If you die, it's... This is the worst level I've ever seen. The worst level in Fire Emblem I've played ever. And it's like, we can't do anything because we've not got 10 superhumans. You know? We've got three. We've got three superhumans. It's like, that's it. Yes, go after them. And move out the way as well. Like, move out the way. So that I can get up to the fucking throne. He's in the way of the throne. Do you see that? He's in the way of the throne. Might be able to kill someone though, with like Kieran, and then Oscar can get in. I don't know. At least the Swordmaster's out, but that dude is blocking the throne there. Please. Fuck! Fucking kill this bitch, you know? Oh man, this is just so horrible. I can't wait for this experience to be over. You know? I really can't though. It's like fucking disgusting. Oh wow, nice dodge, love. We needed it. You know? Still, she's just gonna heal herself, I think. This is also bad. We might not survive another turn. Cause like, I need these guys here as jubation. And if they're just gonna keep getting killed. Stay alive! Stay alive! Yes. This game's fucking trash. You can hold me to that. Fuck's sake. At least they're killing Harlow. Like Joffrey should survive another turn. Just move out the fucking way, bro, please. If I made this game, I'd be fucking disgusted with myself. Nice! He's alive, he's alive, he's alive, he's alive. Are you trying to get yourself killed, mate? He fucking is. You're an idiot. yeah, he doesn't move though, so fuck you. Alright. The worst experience I've ever seen in a Fire Emblem game, and I think there's still worse shit to come. This game is absolutely god-awful, and I do blame the game and its mode as well. I just think this is, like, absolute trash. It's the worst experience I've ever had in this Fire Emblem series. I just don't know. I just don't know what else to say about it. Kill this boss. Kill this boss. Can't even kill him. Nah, it's only a 42. If I could kill him. Ugh. Fuck you. I cannot believe this. Look, he never got healed once in the whole thing. He never even got healed once in the whole thing. Anyway, can we get some XP here? Just a wee bit, you know? Like, I'm not trying to be greedy. Cannot even one-shot this little shitty halberdier. What's going on? I don't even want to, like, risk anything here, if I'm being honest. Yeah. Am I wasting the cabbage? I am wasting the cabbage. Wasting it. I'm glad we got by it, man, because I was fucking... I just couldn't even... Like, just looking at this disgusts me. Do you know what I'm trying to say? Just disgusts me even looking at this bullshit, you know? It's not even fun. It's like... I like hard games, you know, like, I liked almost, like, every Fire Emblem I've played, I've loved the challenge of it. But, like, this is just absolutely disgusting. GG, though. You know? We'll take it. And I don't care about the XP. I really don't, because it would have just been our top units getting the XP. I mean, we could have maybe baited a couple in with Ike here and there, but, pfft, come on.